Hello, it's Sarah, and today I'm going to do a little tutorial for you guys on how to make a pendant using microscope slides and solder and your own artwork. So I was playing around with these yesterday, and I had so much fun. I previously filmed sharing some pendants I made using downloadables. So there's a lot of different ways you can go. But then I started thinking, and you know, last year was my use what you have was my theme. And this year it's still use what you have. I really like that, because I don't like that you think you have to go get all these different supplies. Although I love shopping for supplies, everyone does, but I have a lot of different supplies. So today I'm going to be using Tombow markers, which I'll share with you. Let me just do a share of these. These are super cute. So I was actually inspired to do these by some ATCs that I've made in the past. I went and looked through some of my ATCs, and I have some Zentangled ones and some that I just drew a little picture on, like this. Here's one of them. Here's a little ATC with little birds, and these are punches. The flowers are punches, and I know the butterfly is. But we're just going to draw our little design today. And I chose this one because it's the simplest. It's pretty simple for me to show you how to do. This one's just a Zentangle from, I have this book, Zenspirations, Letters and Patterning by Joanne Fink. So what I get excited about is when I use what I have, old supplies that I've had, and I make it new again. So I have a cold, so I'm going to sniff my way through this. Sorry about that. This is another Zentangle piece, and then my good old, well, this one says Make Today Count, but I love Home Sweet Home. And so let's just get started. Today we're going to work on this guy. I have some watercolor paper, and this is, I think, hot press. It's just what I had, and it's 1x3. So I cut a strip of 1-inch paper, and then I cut it into 3-inch pieces, and so I play with that. And I'm going to take a pencil first, and very lightly I'm going to sketch out the design. And I want you guys to do whatever you want. I'm trying to see if I want to go in a little closer, a little bit. I just thought this was cute for a vertical pattern. You know, it's different. If you were going to do a horizontal pattern, I did do a couple. I don't love how these turned out, this one. I was using my acrylic inks to color this. I was playing with watercolor yesterday, acrylic inks, a bunch of different stuff, but I ended up coming back to the Tombows because they're just so easy to work with. And so that's what we're going to use today. But depending on which way you want to go with your design, I'm going vertical. So I'm going to use this as my guide, and just kind of, so you're going to make a ground. And again, it can be, see how that went down? I don't love that, but don't worry about that. And we're going to go over this. Oh, I should have mentioned, I'm going to use the Micron 01 fine point permanent ink pen to do my final lines on here. So for now, we're just using pencil. And I'm going to put three flowers. I'm going to put a sun up here. I'm going to put a little branch, just gently, and you could kind of make it come like this and have a little, something like that, ugly looking thing. And of course when I'm on camera it's not going to be my best, but it's just a little, almost like a circle, and then you cut in, and this is my bird. You can make little tail feathers if you want. And then I put little leaves coming off here. And I'm going to put a butterfly. And I'm gonna put, I like to put three different flowers. One's down here real low. This is like a rose looking flower. It's really low. This isn't my best work here, guys, but take your time and just have fun with it. And I like to kind of make the stems opposite each other in a way, you know, so it's pleasing to the eye. And when you foil this, so we're going to wrap the pendant with copper foil, it's going to overlap a little bit. So you are going to, you know, you're going to come over your design a tiny bit. So if you come right up to the edge, I really don't like this branch. I want it to be a little thinner. I like that better. And anywho, so just be careful how close you come to the edge. My bird's okay. Everything else is okay. I mean, I'm not in love with it. I think I'll put one more leaf. But that's basically it. So we have this little design on here. And we're going to take our tombos. And first, I'm going to go with my background. And I like to do, I'm going to use a water brush. And I have a little thing of water here, too. Just a little, what are these called? Those mason jars with water in it. So I can use a regular brush just to wet my background. I need a paper towel. But I like to pre-wet my background and drop the color in when I do this because, and I should have put my color out first because this is all going to dry. Let me put my color. So for the background, I chose to use these two colors, 476 and 452. One light and one dark. And I just take a stamp block and put a little bit on the stamp block, both colors, so it's there when I need it. And then I'm going to pre-wet my surface here. Try not to wet the leaves, because the color will bleed into wherever you put the water. And I am not a watercolor artist at all. I love watercolors. I think there's some terrific things you can do with it, but I haven't been able to find someone that explains it to me in a way that I can understand. And so I haven't really, and I want to keep it really light. This is the way to keep it very light. Because you'll see when we do the flowers, I'm just going to go straight onto the paper with my tombos. And, oops, be careful. So you can always add water and dilute it a little bit. But, it's fun to see everyone turns out different when you do this technique. And it really looks artsy. You know, it kind of gives it takes away from that, like, kiddie look, and it becomes really kind of, it really looks artsy, I think, when you do watercolor. Or you might think the opposite, that it just makes it look more kiddish. But whatever you think of it, it's fun, and I don't think you can deny that. And just let the water flow into place and have darks and lights. And when it dries, it looks cool. I didn't even pre-wet this area up here, so I'm just, my brush had a little bit of blue on it, but that's okay. I tend to want it to be a little darkest up against the design. So I love what that looks like. I don't know if it'll stay like that, but I drop color in up against the branch and let it, and maybe up against here. Oops, damn it. It moved. I didn't want it to go on my son. Sometimes you can get it off. It's kind of, it's because my paper is bowing. And I lost some of this other color, the lighter blue. I'm going to put a little bit more on my palette. I don't know where it went. And just drop a little bit of that in. It kind of makes it look, I'm going to try and hold this down. Makes it look like a cloudy sky a little bit. So those of you who are watercolor artists, you don't need my direction to do this. Just get yourself out a piece of watercolor and paper and make a beautiful piece of art. All right, so I'm going to let that dry. And it's all blotchy, and that's okay. I'm going to get some yellow and orange. I love how my son came out. Look what my son did on this one. It bled into the blue because I left it wet there. And I don't know how I did it, but I did it, but I didn't do it intentionally. And I want my water brush. This water. Where's my water brush? This one. I need my paper towel. So I'm going to take the yellow. And see, I didn't pre-wet the surface. And just go yellow. And then I like how that looks though. Like to, and if it bleeds into the blue, that would be okay. I think I'm going to put a little orange in the center of these flowers. And I think I'm going to make the butterfly a little orange and yellow too. But see how it like bled out a little bit into the blue? I like that. Like I kind of want it to do that. I like that. It looks like I meant it to do that. So I don't want to, let's do some green. So I have, let's see, I have three different colors of green out here. A medium, a light, and a, like an olive. And I have my water brush. And let's go with the medium first. I should probably dry it, because I don't want to mess up what I already did. And we're going to hit these leaves up here. Oh look, they're bleeding in. So I have my Q-tip. Just tap it. I don't want that to happen. I think I'm going to... Oh, see it bled into the blue. I could have put more leaves on there. I wish I had. And then I'm going to put this dark olivey green down here. And a little bit of the I like when it mixes together like that. This olivey. And then when it dries, it even like see on this one? Can't really see the olive too much, but there's like it's three tone. I wish I'd have put more leaves. I didn't, but that's okay. And then we'll do, oh, I wanted to do my butterfly yellow. I'm just going to hit this with my heat gun real quick. And that way, at least the blue will be dry. I just want the blue to be dry at least, because now I'm going to go. So this is what I was talking about with my pink. I have this color, 743. I'm thinking I'm going to try the thinner end. And I'm just going to outline the flowers. and come back with my water. This water brush is so pointy. I don't know if I want to use that one. I want to use this one. This one's all beat up. But I'm going to just put some color on the petal and let it pull the color out of the line. See what that looks like. I thought it would shape, like, be dark to light a little more. It looks a little outliney. Oh, you know what I forgot to do is the leaves on the flowers too. What color? I think I'm going to use this light, pretty light green. It looks pretty though. I like how the pink bled up into the blue as well. Hopefully you can see that. I don't want to come in too far because I always get out of the shot if I do that. I think I want to put a tiny bit of the darker green in there too. Oops. Just a tiny bit and see if it, like, right at the center. See how when you touch it, it just pulls up into it? I like that. So I'm just playing, just having fun. And my little bird is going to be red. And I have these two color red. Now let's finish our butterfly. That's just going to be yellow. Trying to keep the palette very... Now, not get too crazy with the colors. I didn't want to put too many colors on here. That looks pretty. And so now we'll do our birdie, and I have red. I just want to do red. See, this is too much pink. I wish I changed it. I don't know. Pink and red are close anyway, so let's see. I just think this will look better. This is red. 856 and 847. And these are very bold. So I think I'm going to try and be very gentle with this. I think I want to pre-wet my little bird first. So I'm putting some on his, not on the wing. And not on the, see, look how that just bleeds into the water. I love it so much. I love playing with color. And that is definitely red. But I can't touch anything else while it's, drying. If I blot it, it'll take out all the pigment, like the color of it. So I'm gonna actually just let it dry. And maybe we'll skip away from that and do the brown for a second. Nah, because I want to do that. Let's see. I'm going to take the lighter color red and just paint it in on his wing. Hopefully it's a different color. Yeah, it's different. Let me just see what this looks like. I don't want to mess it up. I was just going to make lines. I think I'm going to leave it. So we're almost done. We just have to do our branch. And I have, again, two different color browns. Just because I like to put the lighter color and then maybe drop a little bit of the darker color in there. This is $9.47 and $8.79. And I really hope that red is dry. I'm gonna just go in and wet it first. And put the light color. Isn't that cool? And then if I put a little bit of the dark color here and there. I feel so painterly when I do it like that. It just gives it like a little, a two-tone effect, right? Or a, I don't know, but I love it. That's why I kind of wish I did something like that with the butterfly. But I'm liking it. Now it looks a little messy, but we're about to make it all pop. I'm going to dry it real well, and then I'm going to come back in with my Micron Pigma 0.1. Let me just put a little yellow for the beak. I need my really pointy one. And see, a little bit of the red got on that, but that's good because now it's, so that's cool. See, guys, that's it. It's a mess right now, but we're going to fix it. I don't love the way the blue looks in here, but it's okay. See, this is a little piece of work of art. See how different they look? All right, so I got to let this dry. You know what, I'll just stay on camera. You know what I'm going to do first is sign the back. So on here I just signed it. You could put a backing paper too if you want. I'm just putting my name and the year. I don't like that one. That one, and I think this one leaks. Oh no, we're good. I don't know where my, here it is. This one leaks. It's not too bad today. So we're going to outline everything. Gently, because you can't get this off once you. Yeah, I left a little white line there. I don't like that. I'll have to poke it with some red. But now's when you can straighten out your lines and yeah, I don't like that little mark there. And then I did this little going around the darkest pink line, including that in the design. Like, I like that. It looks cool. But it brings it together, doesn't it? It just adds that a little bit of clarity, right? And I could probably add other leaves. Let's see. Little shadow leaves. I don't know. I could probably put a little. I just really, really want to hit that with that red. I'm just going to touch it right here. And I'm just going to touch it with the green. I'm using the thin end. And this is that olive green. Cool. Alright, your artwork is complete. So now, what you want to do is you're going to take two of the microscope slides. Oh, first of all, if you want to add anything like to jazz it up. So like glitter, I didn't put any stickles on here, but let's put a little bit of stickles on our butterfly. Why not? It just adds a little bit of, on, let's see, on this one, I put Winkostella on the whole background. It's not showing up. On this one, I used gel pens, so you can kind of see that there's, I used metallic and glitter gel pens on this one. Anywho, I'm just going to put a little bit of glitter on our butterfly. So I'm just going to squirt it out and use a brush to apply it. That way it's not too thick, because I'm going to be making the, and it might dilute your pen. So just gently, don't rub too hard, just kind of put it down. Because you could smudge. Nothing worse than playing too much and smudging. But that gives it a little pop, right? I just want to put it everywhere. Alright. So I'm going to let that dry. You know what? I'll go away. I'll clear up my desk. And I'll be back with all the stuff we need to solder. All right? So I'll be back with part two. Thanks for watching.